Good morning students, how are you all? Hope you all are doing good. So students, from the last two videos we are discussing about our history chapter 7, that is Ashoka the emperor who gave up war. And we have covered the topics like what is an empire, difference between an empire and dynasty, how was the Mauryan empire established, who have established it. Okay, so these are the details what we have discussed. Then we have seen what is the difference between an empire and a kingdom. So what are the small differences that exist between them, and how efficiently was the administration of Mauryan empire done. So as we have seen, it was very well organized and planned. So and the duties were divided amongst them properly so that there is no confusion and there is no problem occurring between people. So other than that, students, we have also seen how the empire was divided into four provinces. Then the provinces were further divided into districts and into villages. So we have seen that similar structure is followed in our today's administration. So as a country, if we say, it is divided into number of states, and states are divided into districts, and obviously districts will be consisting of cities and villages. So not only that, even we are just like the Mauryan empire, or we can say the previous administration, here we have many people appointed for different jobs to be done. Okay, so yes, these are the topics that we have discussed. But talking about one more important thing, as we are having a capital of our country, what is the capital of our country, students? It is Delhi, right? And the capital of Mauryan Empire was Pataliputra. So this was the old name, students. When the empire existed, during that time it was called as Pataliputra. So do you know what it is called as today? Let me tell you then. It is Patna, and it's in the state of Bihar. Yes. So till now we have discussed about the administration which was followed in empire, then into provinces, then it was again further we have seen how it is divided. But we did not talk about the administration that happened in the capital city. Was it similar? Was anything different or something special was used to be happening in this place? So will you want to see? Okay, then we will see how was the administration in the capital city of Pataliputra. So students, this is the capital city of Pataliputra. As I have kept it in a box, so it will be helpful for you, the marking. Okay students, so I hope whatever points I am telling you, whatever the important places we are discussing in the lessons, you are practicing it after the lesson. If not, then it will become very difficult. So it is better we practice these things one after one and make it easy for our exams. So capital city of Pataliputra, it was direct under the control of emperor. That means we can say the emperor used to reside in the capital city only. So as we have seen, the administration in the other parts of the empire was only very organized. So we here also administration was most complex and well organized. Now we get the information from the source, that the book written by Megasthenes, that is Indiga. A committee of 30 people was appointed to look after the administration of city. That means we are talking about Pataliputra. So these 30 people were divided into 6 groups. That means each group had 5 people from the committee, and also they have an appointed a governor, city governor, who was also called as Nagarika. So we will see what were the work done by these पीपल फ्रॉम द सिक्स ग्रुप्स एंड द नागरिका और दे आर सिंपली सिटिंग. लेट्स सी. सो फर्स्ट ग्रुप, ग्रुप वन इज इंडस्ट्रियल एक्टिविटीज, ग्रुप टू इज एंटरटेनमेंट ऑफ फॉरेनर्स, असाइनिंग देम लॉजिंग, take care of them. So first you might have understood with the name itself that whatever the production or whatever the other industrial activities was happening, they used to take care of those things. Now coming to the group 2, entertainment of foreigners, that means we have seen that these kings were very good at maintaining relationships with the other kingdoms and other countries also. So whenever some foreigners used to come, they used to give the utmost care and importance to them so that when they go back, they tell good about our place and so that it would lead to a good relationship between the empire or the country. Group 3 is registration of births and deaths. So, if somebody is born, it should be get registered, and as well as if somebody is dead, even that has to be registered. Okay. Now, even this happens today also. Now, students, you all might be having your birth certificates. So, once you see your birth certificate, you will get to know the things. Now, where do we get this registrations done? We usually go to some municipal offices. There, they will be doing the registration of birth and death. Government offices. Group 4 is trade and commerce. Checking weights and measures so that there is no fraud happening with the consumers. So we find such similar thing even today, no, consumer rights. We have also seen few time back that there was some movement called Jago Grahak Jago. We used to get a lot of advertisements on TV. Remember? Okay. Group 5 is supervision of manufactured articles. Whatever the things are made, they used to see and they used to supervise them that everything is happening without any mistake. Next, group 6 is collection of taxes and tributes. So even these things are happening today also, children. We see that income tax department, right? Income tax department will be collecting the taxes from all the people. So now, these are the groups which were divided. Now, do we find such groups, students? Yes, there are groups who will be, who are working and taking care of such things. Now, suppose if we have to say industrial activities, today it will be under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Now, if we are seeing about group 2, today it's taken by Foreign Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Then comes the registration is done in our municipal offices. Next, group 4, if we have to see, then there is a Department of Consumer Affairs. That means that all the consumer rights are being practiced properly or not. Is there any kind of fraud happening? So these are the things even still practiced. Next, the supervision of articles. Every place will have a supervisor to see. Okay. Here, group 6, as we already discussed, income tax department is taking care of it now. Okay. So, I think we have almost got the answers for these questions, but still I want you to write it properly in a book. Hope you are doing all the tasks or from all the lessons in a book, students. So you can make a note of the task and do it. So students, we have seen that people who are in the group 6, they are responsible for the collection of tax and tributes. We know what is tax, that we have to pay to the government for the better administration and they provide us facilities. Now what is a tribute? The general meaning of tribute is something that you say or do to show respect or admire somebody or something. So it is, or it should come genuinely. It cannot be done forcefully. As taxes, even we are not happy to give, we have to give, right? So at that time also
they were taking taxes willingly or unwillingly, they have to give. But there was something else called tributes also collected by the people. Now taxes, as we see, they are collected regularly, but tributes was collected as and when it was possible from people who gave a variety of things more or less willingly. That means it was not regular. That if we have to see that earlier farmers used to give 1/6 of their produce, it was compulsory and it was regular. But here tribute is not regular. Whenever the person can give, can afford to give, and how much ever they can afford to give, they will be giving. But it was more or less, when they are saying more or less willingly, students, it means few people cannot afford, but as everybody is giving, even they seeing others, they also think that even we have to do it. So that is the reason they are saying more or less willingly. So students, there is another task, waiting. So here what you are supposed to do is the different types of taxes collected by our government today, and our tributes even collected. Are the government of India still collecting tributes from the people? Okay students, so this is what you have to find out and write the book. So students, we have also seen, no, there was a city governor who was appointed and he was also called as Nagarika. Let's see what were the duties or what were the functions to be carried out by Nagarika. Here, like maintenance of law and order, hygiene, controlling trade, supervising the prisons and cremation grounds. These were the main functions of the Nagarika. So students, almost things you will be knowing, right? Maintaining law and order, seeing that everybody is following the rules and regulations. Hygiene is cleanliness. Controlling trade, so that only they are trading and nothing is going wrong in the trade. Supervising the prison, that if any prisoners are there or any criminals are there, they are supposed to supervise properly without seeing that they are not escaping. And next is cremation grounds. So students, cremation ground is nothing but the place where when a person is dead, the body will be burnt. So such places is called cremation grounds, and the places where dead bodies are buried is called burial ground. Okay. So students, we have seen how is the administration in the capital city of Mauryan Empire took place. So students, now we are going to discuss a new topic, okay, or something related to this only. But before that, I have few questions. So students, who is our Prime Minister? I might have asked you earlier also. He is Mr. Narendra Modi. Yes. So students, have you ever heard this a program called Man Ki Baat? This is a program which he uses as a platform to communicate or to address the people on particular topics or particular issues, whatever is going on in the country. So this program, usually he will be doing it on Sunday, that too 10 a.m. Sunday, as everybody will be free, and at that time everybody will complete their breakfast and they can freely listen what our Prime Minister is willing to say. He will be telecasting the program through All India Radio, DD National and DD News, students. So here DD is nothing but Doordarshan. It is a very old TV channel. People don't use it much, and I think so that you are not even aware of it. So usually whenever Prime Minister Modi have to address something to the people, he will be going through the, he will be doing a Man Ki Baat program. So there is no particular thing that he will be doing next on so and so date. Whenever he wants to address to the people, he will be doing it on Sunday, that is at 10 a.m. Okay. So this was something related to our leader who
does to address us if anything is important that we should know, or what he is planning, or what should be done and what not should be done. He will be addressing us like this. Now, what about the ruler or the leader who used to be in the Mauryan Empire? Whether they used to appear in the people or they used to address the people like this or not? You want to know? Or they used to be always in their forts, in their palaces, resting, or at max to max they used to go for battle. You want to know whether they used to appear in front of people or not? And if yes, how did they appear or how did they show themselves? Let's see.
So students, now we are seeing the emperor and the capital city, whether the emperor used to address the people or not. So yes, on special occasions the emperor used to address the people. He used to go into the people. Now here they have given about an incident that when Chandragupta Maurya has visited to the public, that he appears in the public and they are celebrating with a grand royal procession. So this information we have got through one of our major source of the Mauryan Empire, that is from Indica. Here Megasthenes, he is writing that on special occasions the emperor appears in public are celebrated with grand royal processions. That means he used to go in with a huge crowd. There used to be a very grand mela types. Okay, so he is carried in a golden palanquin. So we usually hear this, no, palki. So he used to be sitting, he will be seated in a golden palanquin, and his guards ride elephants decorated with gold and silver. That means on which he was sitting, the golden palanquin was placed on the elephants, and even the elephants were decorated with gold and silver, students. And it is also said, we cannot tell it 100% that it's true or false, but as Megasthenes have written, there might be some point in it. So he writes that the guards carry trees on which live birds, including a flock of trained parrots, and that used to circle about the head of the emperor. Might be these parrots were trained. So, and they were trained properly that they have to be around the head of the emperor, so that if anybody tries to kill him, it would be difficult. The king is normally surrounded by armed women. That means women soldiers. He is afraid that someone may try to kill him. He has servants to taste the food before he eats. That means there will be many enemies of a king. As we know it, there will be many enemies, right? Now, those enemies will try and they'll keep their full efforts in killing their enemy. So, they can also try to add some poison or do something wrong with the food. So, before emperor eats anything, that would be tasted by the servants. And it is also said that king never sleeps in the same bedroom for 2 nights. If he is sleeping in one room today, tomorrow he'll be in the other room. And about Pataliputra, he writes that it's a very large and beautiful city. It is surrounded by a massive wall. That means this massive wall is forts. And we have learnt about fortification earlier on, in our students. Yes, even this city had fortification. It has 570 towers and 64 gates. The houses of 2 and 3 stories are built of wood and mud brick. The king's palace is also of wood and decorated with stone carvings. It is surrounded with gardens and enclosures for keeping birds. So this is how the overall city of Pataliputra would look like. Students, now there is one more surprise. You will be always happy, no, when task is given. So task 3. So here you have to listen to the latest edition of PM Narendra Modi's Mann Ki Baat program. And what you have to do after listening? You have to list out the things mentioned, what were the topics our Prime Minister has spoken about and what was the main topic of the session. Okay, so this is your homework or task number 3. So students, as we have seen, whenever the emperor used to go out into the public, he used to have the great security around him so that nobody could kill him, nobody would try to kill him. So with this, we can say that there was a very good army. That means if for a small thing, just he is going and appearing to the public, if he is so well secured by the people. Suppose now in a situation where he is going for a war or a battle, what kind of military he might be having. So let's see about the military power of Chandragupta Maurya. Military power of Chandragupta Maurya. When Chandragupta was ruling, so he had a massive army with 6 lakh soldiers. So, and the army was commanded by the Senapati. So, we usually see, right, in many movies, Senapati will be there, the person who will be guiding and giving commands to the soldiers in the army. Soldiers were well trained and well equipped. Equipments, they were having good weapons. Army was divided into 6 branches. So, would you like to see what are these 6 branches? Let's see. First was cavalry. Cavalry is nothing but the soldiers who used to fight in the battle on horses. Next was infantry, the soldiers who used to fight on foot. Chariots, soldiers fighting on chariots. Usually on chariots, they will be people belonging to the royal family or the officials, army officials, king. Only such people would be there on the chariots. Fourth is elephants. That means soldiers fighting on the elephant. We have seen now that Alexander's army was unwilling as they have heard about the armies of the Indian kings. And one of the reason was seeing the elephants. They will be very massive, very big so that they can kill many soldiers easily. Transport. Now students, as we have seen, the cities that were present in the Mauryan Empire, they were very far from each other. They were at very great distances. So, it was very important for them to have a control over the road and the trade. So, as at that time, there were many dakus or dacoits, we can say, waiting. So, seeing that such incidents or such robberies don't happen, there were many soldiers appointed for the transportation to take to see that from one place to the other place the goods are carried safely. Next is navy. So as we have already seen that they were trying to conquer the places overseas also. As they have conquered as Ashoka, and there were many places captured by Chandragupta Maurya also on the coastal sites. So they had trained a navy also. So students, these pictures are not exactly the same, but just for the reference we have used. So this was about the military power of Chandragupta Maurya. So students, one more task waiting for you. So here you have to find out what are the different branches of army today. Do we have the chariots, infantry, cavalry, elephants? So you have to find out whether they are present or not. And are the branches of army existing today similar to the Mauryan military? So this is the homework for you students, and you are supposed to complete it and make sure that you are maintaining a book for it. So students, we have seen in this video about the capital city of Pataliputra, how administration of that place compared to the administration of
our place. Okay, and we have also seen how our Prime Minister addresses the people today, and was there any appearances of the king in the Mauryan Empire. So we have seen, right, the emperor and the capital city of Pataliputra. So next we have also seen about the army, the military power of the Mauryan Empire. So they were divided into 6 branches: cavalry, infantry, chariots, elephants, transport and navy. These were the few. And along with the students, it is believed that the Chanakya, who was the guru of Chandragupta Maurya, had appointed many spies. We say, no, there were many spies. And we also call them as secret agents. Okay. So secret agents were sent to collect the information about the other kingdoms might be. And most important and most interesting fact it is that there were spies to spy the secret agents. Suppose I am going as a secret agent to work in some other place and collect information. Chanakya has appointed one more spy to see that whether I am doing my work properly or not. So such well organized and planned city or planned empire was Mauryan Empire. Okay. So students, we have seen very, very important things today, right? But still our climax is pending. That we will be seeing in our next video. And what is it? Why Ashoka gave up the war. We'll be waiting and we'll meet you in the next video. Till then, bye students. Take care.